Hi everyone, happy new year. It's been a while since I posted a video. This is my first video of the new year and I did feel quite nervous last night thinking I'm going to be making a video today because I was worried I might have forgotten how to do it or feel really awkward or something. But now that I'm back in the seat and I've got my products out, I feel very, very happy to be here and excited to make some new videos. So today I'm going to do a quite peachy golden, not peachy golden, peachy sort of rose goldy makeup because I feel like January is such a grey month, so I'd like to bring some warmth into my eyes and my skin and just do something which is just really flattering really, and it's something that can be adapted for lots of different skin tones and it can be dialed up or dialed down. So the reason, I guess, one of the reasons was that I'd posted on my stories about these really quite reasonable eye palettes that I'd seen in just on the high street that were £4.95 and they had such great colours. And then I thought, what other sort of newish brands or more indie brands do I have that maybe I haven't tried yet or that I've tried and haven't really spoken about? So lots of the products I'm going to use, some of them you've seen before, but they are generally not so much the big brands, they're more of the small indie brands. So I've already done one layer of skincare, and this is the Cosmetic Immunity, and it's the Luminous Skin Defense, is it called? Yep. So I'll put a second layer on. So if I'm looking quite shiny, it's because my skin is really dehydrated at the moment. So I think it's just being in a heated environment and it's very cold outside. So my skin has got dehydrated. And this is a brand, I'd call this an indie brand, it's a Korean brand, but I have used it quite a lot in my last few videos as well. So you would have seen it before. So I'm looking nice and shiny there. So I'm going to do my eye makeup before I do my base. So you have to just put up with me looking this shiny for a while. Before I start my eyes, I thought I'd try this Alpine Beauty, and this is Plant Genius. And I've been sent a lot of their products, like the cleanser, and I just haven't had time to use them, but they look really nice. It's an American brand, I believe. And this is their Line Smoothing Eye Balm. And I thought I'd put a really thin layer of this just under my eyes. It's got a little bit of shine to it, a little bit of pearl in it. But I think I'm mainly just going to use it almost where I would use my highlighter, kind of here, which is a little bit dry at the moment. I'm also going to use a little bit on my eyelids as well, since it's line smoothing. It's a wild crafted sort of natural brand. It does feel really nice. It doesn't feel greasy at all, but it feels quite, looks quite blurring, shall we say. So let's see how that goes. So I'm going to use, I think, a mixture of these two, which is the Rust palette and the Rose Golds. So these kind of warm colours. I think I'm going to use some of the pinky tones and some of the peachy tones. So I'm just going to use my mirror. Some people keep asking me where this mirror is from and I can't remember. I think I might have just ordered it on Amazon and it doesn't have any, it doesn't say where it's from. It doesn't have any branding on it. And there was a moment when I ordered lots of different mirrors. So if I find it, I will put down below what it is, but at the moment I can't find where I got it from. So this is just a kind of a natural brownie tone I'm going to use first. So these, for nine shades, it's £4.95. So there we go. Just do a sort of wash of that colour. And this is a colour that you may have. It's quite matte, but it's gone on really nicely, considering the price of that. I think I'm going to use, before we start to build on top, I'm going to do a little wash of the same colour just along my lower lash line as well. Oh, I do have this quite huge lump here. Probably doesn't look huge, but it is huge under the skin. Okay, so next I'm going to use, which colour shall I use? I'm going to go into more of these sort of rusty colours and we're going to try maybe sort of these three here. So more of the sort of rusty, the bronze and the pink. So I'm just going to blend this. It's at the outer edge. That looks sort of peachy. Oh, for the price, these are really nice to apply. I don't know if it's because I put that the smoothing balm underneath, but they're certainly gliding on. And they don't need a lot of blending. Next, I'm going to use this more pinky shade as an eyeliner. It's not too pinky, so it won't look like rabbit eyes. I'm just spraying with some Cora Rose Mist, just to wet the brush a little bit before I do that. And then just go along on the top, on both sides. Okay, next I'm going to use the deeper shade that's in this palette, just at the outer edge there. And there is a sort of slightly glittery shade here that probably will apply better with fingers, I would think, than a brush. So a little go of that. Maybe just a touch in the center. Since I'm not doing a full on kind of night look. I like these colors. Okay, so now I'm going to do base, but I just need to check if I've got anything dropped down. Wow, hardly anything dropped down at all. That's pretty impressive. Tiniest amount, which I'll just clean off with the mist. Very good. Look, hardly anything came off it. Okay, for base, I'm going to use the Ilia, and this is the Serum Foundation. So slightly more indie brand. And this is, because it's a serum foundation and it's a brand that likes to incorporate quite a lot of skincare into their products, I thought this would be good for this time of year because it will, it's not going to have a lot of coverage, but it's going to be more probably kinder to my skin. It does still contain silicone, so it is going to set and hopefully stay. Well, that's very nice to blend. Very easy. Let's see if it covers my monster spot. No, I don't think you'll know that. It's not as good as that. But I don't want to put a really heavy coverage on anyway. Because as you guys know, my philosophy is always use a lighter foundation and then you can go back in if there's anything major that needs concealing and use concealer. So that's just a light layer all over. It smells really good. It smells like, God, I don't know what to call that. Rose hip, maybe? Okay, so I'm noticing that this is very shiny. This is too shiny for me. I've given it a minute to settle in, so I will definitely need to powder this, but I'll powder it later. But this, I think, would be really nice if you had very dry skin. Mine's more dehydrated, but I wouldn't say it was very dry skin. So it does look nice. It looks very natural, but it's definitely too shiny for me. So I'll come back to that. So next thing we're going to use is this highlighter, Illuminating Veil by Danessa Myricks. And this is a makeup artist that I follow on Instagram. And she posts all these really kind of highlighted, beautiful, very, very glowy looks. And this is quite a strong highlighter. I'm only going to use a tiny amount, but I really like it because it's an independent brand owned by her. She hasn't got any investment. She does really good products. And I also liked her story that she was more of an accidental makeup artist. So she kind of got into it by default. And now she's become this really big makeup artist and does lots of celebrities' makeup and things. So You can see it's got quite a lot of shine on it, so I'm going to use a really small amount. And actually, now is the perfect time because this foundation is really quite luminous and still feels almost quite wet on my skin. It means that I'm going to be able to really seamlessly blend this highlighter. So I'm going to add it onto the high points of the cheeks. Maybe a little bit onto my middle of my nose. And I'm going to really blend this in so it's totally seamless. I'll do my concealer after. So that, again, will take down a little bit of the fact that it is quite strong shine. Although for nighttime, I think this is going to be gorgeous. It's just during the day, I don't like to look personally too shiny. Like particularly, I don't like to look metallic. But this is really easy to blend anyway. I'm going to use a brush just to really smooth that in. So use quite a big kabuki brush just to make sure that that is really seamless so we don't see where it starts and where it finishes. So next I'm going to use some concealer. I'm going to use this one by Hint, which I think I might have used before in a natural makeup tutorial that I did. And this is a brand, I've forgotten the name of the owner, but it's a lady in New Jersey that had breast cancer, and she developed a brand around all of the ingredients that she was comfortable having in her cosmetics. And I really like these concealers. So I'm just going to use this mainly underneath my eyes, and then I'm going to use it also onto any spots that I have. I might use a sponge actually to just blend this in because it's quite creamy. Again, this is a small brand, quite a nice indie brand, female owned. It's always nice, I think, when someone almost develops products for themselves because it really does have that authenticity, which I really like. I definitely need to powder now, though. I feel like my skin is feeling quite overly dewy. So for powder, I'm going to use the Manessi 7, and this is the Silk and Silica powder. And this is a wild harvested silk powder, so it's not a vegan product, but it's described as a semi-matte powder. It's loose and really fine, so it's a mixture of the silk and the silica. So I'm going to, under my eyes, it's so fine, I mean it's hardly got any powdery feel to it at all. I'm going to actually use it with a puff, which I wouldn't normally do, but I think it's because it's so fine and I do feel like I need to set this foundation and also this concealer because it is quite creamy. I mean, it's literally, you can't see that on the skin. Ah, my God, that feels soft. That feels so silky. And I'm going to use a powder as well. A brush as well. And take the shine off. This really is the silkiest, softest powder. And I do like the fact that it's described as a semi-matte because although I feel too shiny at the moment, I don't want to make myself look incredibly, I don't want to lose all of that. I still want to look glowy. I'm going to use it on this is where my largest pores are, and it's they're completely gone. Wow. It's a very blurring powder. So where I am going to leave it is just round the sides where I've got this beautiful highlighter. I'm going to set my spot, but I'm going to go back in and conceal that. If you've seen my how to conceal a large spot, you'll know that it takes a little bit of work because it's more about almost concealing the shadow that the spot casts than anything else. So we're going to come back to that. We're going to let that settle in. Let that settle on with the powder, and that's quite a good tip. Don't feel that if you can't nail it the first time with these spots, it's better to apply a small amount of product and maybe even set and go back in. Better thin layers sort of built up than lots and lots of product, which very often doesn't even conceal properly. So I think that's actually now a really nice base. So I don't feel, I feel like it's set now and it feels very, wow, gosh, this is so soft, it's crazy. But I still feel like I have all that glow. So next thing I'm gonna use, I think I'm gonna do my eyelashes next so I can finish my eyes and move on to my brows. So I'm gonna use the Troy Surratt eyelash curlers and just really give them, my eyelashes, a good curl. So before I apply my mascara, I'm just using this eyelash primer. And I've been using this for about the last month and I really like it. It's an indie brand called Code Beautiful. It's owned by two sisters. And I just think this is a really good, almost like if you want, not a false lash effect, but to really volumize the lashes. And my eyelashes aren't great at the moment. I haven't been using any of my serums. I just got out of the habit really. And particularly on the lower lashes, I have started using some serums again, so I just need to stay on the case. So apply this before, and it just thickens them. They don't look too nice while it's on because they look almost like a very ashy sort of beigey colour. And then over the top, I'm going to use the Clio makeup, and this is the Lash Love. Is it called that? Dark Love, sorry, mascara. And I've used this, I've tried this before. This is a really nice mascara. I'm not sure if you're supposed to let the primer dry, but I haven't. Usually a bit too impatient for that. But you can see, even with quite a volumizing mascara like this, the eyelashes are still staying pretty separated. So before I move on, I'm just going to stipple a touch more concealer, not just on the spot, but over the entire area, just to blend it in a bit more. And then using a slightly warmer, the slightly warmer shade, just a touch more on the actual spot. Then I'm going to set that again. It is very much like digital retouching of the skin. Okay, now that's gone. Okay, so next I'm going to do brows, and I'm going to use the Kimiko brow pencil. You've probably seen me use these before. It's a makeup artist called Danielle Vincent, and her middle name apparently is Kimiko. And these are just great eyebrow pencils. I love them. Again, a really small indie brand, female owned, made in Japan. So all of her eyebrow pencils are made in Japan and they're just great. The colors are really good. She's got a real makeup artist eye for color and they're so fine. And they really stay on, so I love them. Just filling in some gaps, mainly just up on the high point and underneath the center there. And just a couple of strokes at the front. This one I'm going to brush it down just because there's a gap underneath. So just in there, there's like a dip, which almost shortens my eyebrow and stops my eye getting a nice lift there. So by brushing down and just filling in behind, if you can see there on the skin, I just open up this eye and lift it. I feel like these pencils are quite foolproof. Okay, before we move on, I'm going to finish my eyes. I'm going to use this bronzy pencil just under my waterline, a little bit under the lashes, just very lightly. This is by a Norwegian brand that I don't have a lot of information about because all of their information is in Norwegian. So I think it's just a brand which sells in Norway. But some of their products, a couple of them are really nice. I might actually use as well a little bit of eyeliner. I'm going to use this refillable one by Sensai. So this isn't, I guess this isn't really an indie brand. This is more of a mainstream Japanese brand that I like. Just going to use this at the outer corner. This is what I mean about sometimes you don't have to do things in sequence, because you always see people use their eyeliner before the mascara, which is a good idea if you know you're definitely going to do liner. But it's not the end of the world if you decide after you've done your mascara, oh, actually, I think a little bit of definition, a little bit of extra eyeliner is going to go down well. So I think what I'm trying to say is there's no particular order that you need to do things in. And I just feel like I just want a touch of extra kind of darkness just at the outer corner there. So I'm just dabbing this. It's almost like I'm not drawing a perfect line. It's more of a sense of something which is defining at the outer edge. So I'm just going to redo my lower lash line now. I'm going to use those two colours that I use, the pink and the brownie colour. So I'm going to use the brown just softly along the whole lash line, just to slightly smoke the effect. And then the pink one, this is the one I used as the eyeliner when I used it with the wet brush, the damp brush. I'm quite confident this is not going to drop down, so I feel quite happy about doing this when I've got my base all perfected. And that under eye concealer has not creased. And the powder, I'm obsessed with this powder. Can't see any pores. So this again is the pink shade, just at the outer edge there. And then I'm going to use a clean brush of some description. I think it can be just a nice fluffy brush. I don't really have one, might just use this. Just going to go over all of that eyeshadow on the top. I'm going to use this for blush, but it's fine because the blush colour is going to be quite similar to this rosy bronze that I've got on the eyeshadow anyway. Here we go. I'm also going to go back in with my mascara just on the lower lashes. So next I'm going to use this sculpting palette, which is blush and contour. It's also got a highlighter, but I'm very happy with the highlighter I have already. So I'm not going to use that. So I'm going to start with the contour. Just use a tiny bit of that. And then I'm going to use the same brush that I use with the powder, just because I feel like this powder mixed with blush is going to feel so nice. It's going to really smooth the colour on. This colour is very similar to NARS Orgasm. So it's got that peachy, goldy, flushed look. I'm building up slowly because I believe this has got quite a lot of payoff. So I'm doing a dab and then a dab on my arm. And then just rolling it on, really. Just so it stays looking really well blended. Because I've got my spot here, I should be okay because we've got the powder on and we're using the brush that had the powder. So nothing should stick to that. But I may have to go in afterwards and conceal it again. No, I think it's good. Use a touch of that just onto the brow bone as well. Just to blend that in, give it a nice seamless look. Next, I'm going to use a lip pencil, and this is Nude by Nature, which is an indie Australian brand. I've got a bit of concealer actually on my, or foundation, I should say. On my lips already, but don't worry, I'm going to use some gloss over the top. Just using this pencil to overdraw slightly on the bottom and define on the top. So on top of that, I'm going to use, and this is the Norwegian brand I was talking about earlier on, which is Amberlee, and I'm going to use this lip gloss of theirs. I just really like the colour. It's got quite a good payoff. So I'm doing a couple of final touches here. Just using the under eye brush again, the fluffy one. Sorry, this wasn't the under eye brush. This was the one for the top. But now that it's got hardly anything on, I'm just using it to really smoke out underneath the eyes. So it's the same kind of pinky rose colours, just to soften that effect. I'm also going to use just a little spritz of rose mist, since we've gone for a rosy effect. Mmm, smells so good. That's the Cora Organics. Just to keep it all very glowy. And I think that's the finished look. It has definitely taken the edge off my dehydrated grey winter skin. And I'm feeling positively almost sunset, tropical sunset, which is not a bad thing here in the Northern Hemisphere at this time of year. So I really enjoyed using all of these indie brands, and I hope that was fun and helpful. See you soon.